The matter don't cast. Legend versus legend, new cats versus new cats, fans versus fans, all fighting to prove that Burna Boy was either helped or not helped in his career. All fighting to prove that Burna Boy was helped or not helped. Burna Boy said he wasn't helped, but some people are saying he was helped. I don't know if those people will tell Burna Boy's story way more better than him. I don't know, but let us see. Now it has involved another legend. You know, Eedris AbdulKareem came out and was running his mouth. I just feel like Eedris AbdulKareem should have kept quiet. It's none of his business. Well, guess what? One of our Psquare's brother, that is Rude Boy, slammed Eedris AbdulKareem for using Burna Boy as blunt just cause he's about to drop a new song, and further dragging for betraying them during the 50 Cent incident many years ago. But always fast to go on podcast and speak on artists anytime he wants to drop music. Well, Eedris AbdulKareem is about to drop a song, and that's one of the reasons he's doing some media appearances, and he decided to bring out Burna Boy's name. Yeah. Some of all those artists just feel like whenever they want to release a project, it is good to call out one of those big artists so that people can give you attention, and then maybe you can make some money from it. Eedris AbdulKareem, man, sorry to say, you are a living legend. Eh? Sorry, but your music no go blue. Sorry to say, but you are a legend who have retired a long time ago. And you know, if you retire from music, it is hard for you to retire. That is how it is about music. And meanwhile, let us read what Psquare wrote. Rude Boy about Eedris AbdulKareem. He said, "Every AK market day, we go the hear. I fought for the industry. Now me cook the food where you na the chop. I go just the laugh. Now you want reply with music. You go reply tire. Over 20 years I have kept silent about what really transpired. How we topped Nigeria artists as of then agreed with one voice about payment, condition and treatment on the same 50 Cent show. Only for this greedy guy to go behind and collect peanuts. You they expect VIP treatment on top peanuts payment. You keep insulting any artist at every opportunity. If he's not Two-Face, he's Psquare, Timaya, the band. Now Burna Boy, you go explain tire." That's coming from Psquare. That's coming from Psquare, Rude Boy. They were there when that incident happened of Two-Face between Eedris AbdulKareem and 50 Cent. They were there live. They witnessed everything. They had a meeting prior to that event, and they said if they must bring 50 Cent to this event and they pay 50 Cent such huge amount of money, they should also at least be able to treat us the way they would treat 50 Cent. They should also give us 5-star hotel. But Eedris AbdulKareem went behind their back, according to Psquare, to collect peanuts, and he was asking for only for 5-star hotel and every executive VIP treatment only for himself. And meanwhile, they were supposed to go. Meanwhile, they were supposed to speak in one voice. But Eedris AbdulKareem went behind their back, collect peanuts. And meanwhile, you know, Eedris AbdulKareem have his own fight with Charlie Boy. You know, this one call out this one. This one call out this one. This one call out this one. Well, for me, I'm just concerned about Burna Boy. Burna Boy wasn't there as I did. You understand? Burna Boy is the new cat of this era, alongside with their Wizkid and their own Davido. They are all new cats of this era. So why you and old cat would they carry your mouth pull for new cat business? They said Burna Boy they arrogant. Let's be honest. Has Burna Boy responded to this man recently? No. Did Burna Boy even know if Eedris AbdulKareem was leaving? No. Has Burna Boy even replied to what he said? No. Did Eedris AbdulKareem help Burna Boy ever in his career? No. Do Eedris AbdulKareem know people who have helped Burna Boy? No. So tell me, how come someone who wasn't even part of your growth, someone who wasn't even part of your growth, we start making all sorts of comments about. So someone explained to me, how come someone who never contributed to your growth, someone who wasn't even there when they were contributing to your growth, someone who never knew you were able existing while you were still trying to build up yourself, now comes out to tell your story way more better than you, because it feels like you are arrogant. It feels like in this life somebody must help person. Even if we know somebody must help person, that doesn't mean a total stranger will come to my face and tell me I was helped. No. If there should be any person who, if there should be anybody that will tell Burna Boy if he was helped, should be someone who actually helped Burna Boy. So for me, in this matter, I will totally support Burna Boy anytime, any day. When it comes to this particular, if he was helped or not. Wait till concern Eedris AbdulKareem. How many people Eedris AbdulKareem help? He get record label, then be like, say, he bring out many artists. How many people he help? Let's be honest. How many people he help? How many people did Eedris AbdulKareem help? Did he help Two-Face or help any other guys that we never knew? Let him come outside now. Since he's talking about help. Somebody will say, give respect to Eedris AbdulKareem. Who are you? You, this new person. Do you know how they fought? Fought for what? If an old man cannot hold respect upon himself, why should anybody give him respect? When a old man is trying to rub shoulders with young boys, why won't they give him disrespect? Why would they give him disrespect? Honestly, come on, man. The life is so simple. Have respect for yourself and you will be accorded the same respect. If you decide to disgrace yourself and rub shoulder with youngies, you will get the same disrespect. It's as simple as that.
Burna Boy, which you call yourself, make we know our mates now. You were 8 years old when he dreams with remedies, really Shakomo. But now you are talking to him, you are even dragging his LT to it. Waiting now, you don't get respect. What did he say that was wrong? Say, because you talk with him, you now say you blame those that contributed. You don't know tomorrow. You don't control your health. It's God that controls health, and then you drag him by health. Who you be now? What Nigerian entertainment enjoys today, music-wise, started from people like Plantation Boys, The Remedies, and the host of them, and the rest of them. And you will just come. You can't brag. They drag and say, make una no meet. What do you go do? You don't know your mates. Idris now your mates. When you enter the music industry, where you call the follow Idris, you were 8 years old when you reached Shakomo. And that, we know they count all the years where they sing for FCO, for Kano. Now, don't we know, say 1999, where you begin, you don't they sing before you were born. Where did they sing? They never born you. But now you they brag. You say, make una no meet for Kano. What do you go do? My guy, respect yourself. Oh.
Make una see tell Idris, make you respect yourself too. Now, if not, nobody go they call a name like this. Abba. Let's call a spade a spade. Eedris has worked so much, despite some of his mates at that time, still have one or two things to say about Eedris for being a fake person, according to Debo. Like what Psquare Rude Boy said, that Eedris was a fake person, a snitch, all those kind of stuff. And waiting, Eedris go talk about Charlie Boy also, that Charlie Boy is not a truthful person when it comes to money. You know, everybody get waiting to talk to his elders. Charlie Boy is an elder to Eedris AbdulKareem, but Eedris AbdulKareem talked about Charlie Boy anyhow. Eedris AbdulKareem is an elder to Psquare, but Psquare just revealed the truth anyhow. Now, just revealed the truth about, according to Psquare, his own version of Eedris AbdulKareem. So if you still carry your man, go Burna Boy, be expecting that Burna Boy to talk about you. If you want to see, man, let us, all those elders, let them chill and relax, man. Abba, chill and relax. Eedris AbdulKareem, stop putting yourself in the midst of this old small boy's new cat issue. Remove yourself from there, not to get any form of disrespect from fans, from his family, and from any promoters who might be supporting Burna Boy. And you know you're about to drop a song. Why don't you drop your song well and promote it well. How about drop your song well and promote it well? How about now? Stop bringing yourself into the mix of all those small boys. Yes, I will call them small boys because Eedris AbdulKareem, that's why we are just calling his name. It's somebody who has really worked really hard. He's too strong against Olusegun Obasanjo when they sang Nigeria Jaga Jaga. Everything is scatter, scatter. Poor man, the sofa, sofa, boza, boza. One shot on the air. And also, my lecturer gave me the promo, all those kind of that music, man. I love that music then. I'm still a huge fan, but that time is up, man. That time is up. That time is up. I'm still a fan, though, but their time is up. So chill, Eedris AbdulKareem, man. Allow these young geese to enjoy themselves. Allow these young geese to be on top. Huh? Don't bring yourself into their midst, not to get dragged, disrespected. They owe you, Eedris AbdulKareem. They owe you. Come on, man. You are too big for that ish. You are too big. Burna Boy never respond now. If Burna Boy respond now, they will say, oh, he's arrogant. He's arrogant. Why is he responding? You don't know him, mate. You don't know him, mate.